Let us take the numerical on this boundary layer. Find the displacement thickness, momentum thickness and energy thickness for the velocity distribution in the boundary layer given by small u by capital U is equal to 2 into y by delta minus y by delta square. Same velocity profile we are going to take. Now I have told you that the boundary layer is expressed in terms of velocity inside that boundary layer, and that velocity is expressed as a function of y, that is the distance perpendicular in perpendicular direction, and capital U, it is the free stream velocity, and delta, it is the boundary layer thickness. Now the numericals are very simple for boundary layer theory, because there is only the formula and you have to just put the values in that formula and get the answer. So first, the displacement thickness, as we have seen the formula for displacement thickness, delta star is equal to 0 to delta 1 minus small u upon capital U dy. So small u upon capital U, the velocity profile is given to you, it is 2 into y by delta minus y by delta square. Just put the value of small u by capital U inside the integral, integrate over 0 to delta, and you will find the answer for displacement thickness. When you solve this integration, you will get, and apply the limits, you will get the answer for displacement thickness as delta by t. So the displacement thickness is 1/3 of the boundary layer thickness. So that is the answer for the displacement thickness. Next, we have to calculate the momentum thickness. Again, you have to remember the formula for momentum thickness. Just the formula for momentum thickness or energy thickness, they are near about same to that of the displacement thickness, which we have seen that it is U by capital U into 1 minus U upon capital U. That is, for momentum thickness, just you have to multiply by small u upon capital U to the term 1 minus small u by capital U of the displacement thickness. When you again integrate this, just put the value of small u upon capital U, that is the velocity profile equation, 2y by delta minus y square by delta square. You will find the answer for the integration. When you solve the integration, you will get the momentum thickness as 2 delta upon 50. You have to carefully solve the integration. And last, that is the energy thickness, delta double star. Again, the formula for it, we have already seen, it is 0 to delta small u upon capital U, but inside the bracket, now not 1 minus u upon capital U, it is 1 minus u square, small u square upon capital U square, and integrate it over 0 to delta. So after performing the number of steps of the integration, you will again get the energy thickness, again in terms of boundary layer thickness, that is 22 delta upon 105. So the main point here is that the three formulae for displacement thickness, momentum thickness and energy thickness that you have to remember, and just put the value of velocity profile equation and integrate it to get the thickness. So this is the numerical on boundary layer theory. So I think we have come to an end of the first part of this unit. I have told you that we have divided it into three parts. So first part is boundary layer theory, the reason behind it and the terms involved in it. So now let us come to the second part of this boundary layer, that is the forces on the submerged bodies or on the solid bodies. Now, already I have told you that when this fluid is heating to the solid body, it is exerting some force on the solid body, and that force is nothing but it is acting in the normal direction to that body. Okay. But when you resolve that force along horizontal and vertical direction, then you are getting two components of that forces. And out of that, the horizontal component is called as a drag force and the vertical component is called as a lift force. So if you see in the figure, when the fluid is sheeting to the solid body, which is kept at some angle with the horizontal, then that fluid is striking the body in normal direction, to the inclined body. So if you see the normal component, that is Fr, is the normal component of the force, or it is the normal force acting on the inclined solid body. And then you are going to resolve this normal force into two components, one horizontal and one perpendicular. So the horizontal component, as already I have told you, it is a drag force, and the vertical is the lift force. So I think from the diagram the two forces are clear to you. Now the question is how to find this drag force and the lift force. Now there is a very big theory for finding the drag and lift force, that you have to use the momentum equation, that is the Newton's second law of motion, as we have studied in your unit number 3, that is the fluid dynamics, okay, to calculate the forces. Okay, under that we have used the Newton's second law of motion, that is nothing but Euler's equation of motion. Now here also you have to use that equations, but after doing the rigorous calculations you are going to end at some formula, and instead of going through that long step calculations, what is important from exam point of view, that only I am taking in this unit only, that is in this topic. So I have directly written the expression for the drag and lift force. Now as you know, that force is nothing but stress multiplied by area. If it is normal force, then normal stress multiplied by the area. If it is normal area, if it is a tangential force, then it is a tangential stress or shear stress multiplied by the shear area. Like that we are going to find the drag and lift force in this case. So first, the drag force is simply, it is given by area into the stress, but here the stress is expressed in terms of some quantity, that is given by rho u square by 2. So in the expression, Fd is equal to Cd into capital A into rho u square by 2, that you see in the slide. In that expression, it is calculated as area. Capital A is nothing but the area perpendicular to that particular direction, projected area, multiplied by the shear stress. If it is shear, if it is drag, it is shear stress naturally. That is expressed by rho u square by 2. And Cd is nothing but, it is the coefficient of drag. Okay, as already I have told you that there are rigorous calculations in calculating this drag force. But combining all this, we have taken a constant, okay, in that equation, that is called as Cd. For the time being, you only remember the equation. Fd is equal to Cd into capital A rho u square by 2. And Fl is equal to Cl into capital A rho u square by 2. Okay. So, based on this, there are numericals, and very simple numericals on lift and drag. Because the formula are simple, everything is given to you, just you have to calculate the drag and lift force, and thereby the power required for that. Okay. So, let us take the numericals, and remember, after calculating the drag and lift force, you can take the resultant to calculate the resultant force on the body. As shown in the slide, Fr is equal to under root of Fd square plus Fl square. So let us take first problem based on the lift and drag. A flat plate 1.5 meter by 1.5 meter area moves at 50 km per hour in stationary air of density 1.15 kg per meter. Full stop. If the coefficient of drag and lift are 0.15 and 0.75 respectively, determine lift force, drag force, resultant force and power required to keep the plate in motion. So it's a straightforward problem. In that, area of the plate is given, velocity of the plate is given. Now in this case, the fluid is not moving, the plate is moving. So it is either or, either the body will move, the fluid will be in stationary condition, or in some numericals the fluid will move and the body will be in stationary condition, vice versa. But there is no much effect, because according to Newton's third law, both are exerting force on each other. So no problem in that. Whatever is the moving body, that you have to take as the velocity of that body. So let us solve this numerical. In this numerical, as we see that the area is 1.5 meter by 1.5 meter, CD is 0.15, and rho is also given 1.15. So just you have to calculate the velocity, 50 kilometer per hour, you have to convert it into meter per second. So if you see the solution, area is calculated as 2.25 meter square, velocity is coming as 13.89 meter per second, rho is 1.15 kilogram per meter cube, CD is 0.15 and CA is 0.75. Just you have to use the formula for drag as FD is equal to CD into capital A into rho U square by 2. Put all the values that are given already and just calculate the drag force. It is coming as 37.44, and calculate the lift force, which is coming as 187.20 newton. So if you see, the force, the lift force is more than the drag force in this case. So it is a good sign that lift force is always helping the body for lifting in air, for lifting the body in air. And the drag force, it is the opposition to the motion of the body, like in case of aeroplane. So drag force should be as low as possible, so that you will require less fuel for the aeroplane. The resultant force you can calculate by Fd square plus Fl square. Under root of that,